错过的流年。
Mama nama kes Juni Jawi, anak roh cafu kamanin.
And your dad?
What about him?
Does he show you that he likes you?
My dad loves me.
Ungekuwa umejishughulisha na maisha yako hatungefika hapa.
Nyota wako iko salama.
You look so surprised to see me.
It's here, I'm shocked.
Hao si mambo ya kawaida, mwisho atanyoka.
Kwangu sina muda. Wakati unayoona.
There are more important things than knowing my interest, right?
No. Clarify the situation.
All of this would be all right if you proved that the ranch is under your name. So is it or not, Daddy? Because if it isn't, the Mendozas would be right to dispute the ownership.
That's all I needed to hear. My own child going against me.
I'm sorry, Fabricio.
You're sorry?
Yes, that's right.
But I'm warning you, it won't be easy. These cases always happen to be long drawn out affairs, and according to the law, that man apparently has a strong case if he has paid for all of the expenses of the ranch.
The Amazons.
Log on to the KBC website at www.kbc.co.ke to get the latest breaking news, entertainment, sports, politics, lifestyle or business trends from Kenya and around the world. Never miss new episodes from your favorite TV shows, reruns and movies. Just stream online or watch live on your YouTube channel at KBC Channel 1 TV Shows for the day's biggest stories, trustworthy news and family entertainment. Log on to KBC Channel 1. Watch what you want anytime, anywhere.
It is the 19th day of October 2021, just a couple of hours to the national event Mashujaa Day in Kirinyaga County. Thank you indeed for joining us. My name is Bentro Njue, and Susan Wathuku will be our sign language interpreter for this afternoon. Remember, you can be part of this broadcast via our social media spaces or platform at KBC Channel 1. Remember, we are also live on Facebook and also on Twitter. Straight to the news, the National Cohesion and Integration Commission has embarked on a week-long sensitization drive in Nakuru County in a move aimed at creating and cementing peaceful coexistence between members of the public, political actors in the run-up to the 2022 general election. According to NCIC Civic Education and Advocacy Deputy Director Killian Nyambu, the commission will engage the national government administrative officers, Nyumba Kumi initiative officers, and other peace actors within the 47 counties to preach peace as political activities take shape ahead of the 2022 elections.
One of the strategies engagement with the local
actors within their respective safe spaces to be able to interrogate their specific contribution towards this, because we appreciate that the commission alone cannot be able to guarantee peace.
A family in Mombasa is appealing for help in tracing their 22-year-old kin, Mohammed Abubakar. Abubakar was allegedly abducted by unknown armed men led by Mombasa Senator Mohammed Faki. The family is calling upon the security agencies in the county to assist them in locating their relative.
Mohammed Abubakar Said, a student at Umma University, was picked at gunpoint by men posing as security agents at around 8:30 p.m. as he was heading home from the Isha prayers at Masjid Azhar in Majengo.
Na sisi tunajua katika Mombasa County ama pwani kwa jumla hakuna magenge yanayotumika kuteka watu nyara kiolela. Kwa hivyo moja kwa moja tunajua kwamba hii ni kazi ambayo imefanywa na maafisa wa polisi kupitia vitengo vyao vya usalama.
Senator Mohammed Faki said the Senate is expected to debate a report of missing persons, especially at the coast, giving hope for victims and their families on the way forward.
Kwa hivyo tuambia serikali kwamba hili swala hili la kuteka nyara ni swala ambalo ni mikononi mwa serikali. Kwa sababu ndugu yetu Sagar tulisema ni serikali kutoka mwanzo na mwisho alimwachilia.
Sagar's abduction and the consequent admission by security agents that they had held him triggered Faki's planned motion. Faris Rubea, the Norwegian International Society for Justice and Peace ambassador, said they are not opposed to police doing their work, but insisted they must do their work within the confines of the law.
Lakini hizi habari za kwa kila siku watoto wanatekwa nyara zimekuwa nyingi sana. Zimekuwa nyingi sana, especially kwa upande wetu wa coast. Na sijui kwa nini coast hizi mambo ndo yanatokea sana. Sisi tunaomba salama, tunaomba justice.
Moving on, parents and students at the Many Heart Secondary School in Kilifi North Constituency are demanding the ouster of the current board of management, the school principal and his deputy, accusing them of running down the school. The parents claim that the principal and his deputy were responsible for the poor results that the school has been posting in national examinations.
Trouble is brewing at the Many Heart Secondary School in Kilifi constituency, with parents and students accusing the school leadership of running down the school. A meeting held on Monday at the school compound to resolve the matter did not go as planned. Irate parents and students expressing their displeasure at what they term as dismal performance in the national examinations and the withdrawal of the lunch program.
Shida kubwa ni kwamba progress ya shule iko chini sana. Na hiyo progress iko chini ni kwa sababu walimu hawawajibiki. Na kwa sababu ya kutowajibika walimu ni principal mwenyewe hawajibiki. Maana angekuwa anatekeleza kazi yake vizuri, majibu yangekuwa na improvement.
Watoto hawasomi vizuri kwa sababu, nitasema watoto hawasomi vizuri kwa nini? Hmm. Mtoto yule ataingia shule asubuhi, ikifika saa 4 amefukuzwa ameenda nyumbani, aje atafute pesa kwa mzazi. Mzazi ni awe ana pesa. Akiwa hana pesa mzazi, itabidi mtoto aregeshwe tena shule. Akiregeshwa shule anakuja nafukuzwa pamoja na mzazi mwenza na mzazi wake. Yule mtoto kweli atasoma?
The chairperson of the board of management, Christine Karani, is however blaming the poor performance on indiscipline among the students.
Watoto hawana discipline. Na watoto kupata discipline ndio inaongeza ya watoto kuwa na performance nzuri. Pili, mambo ya wazazi halizao za uwezo wa kulipa fees ziko chini sana. Kwa hivyo wengi wametegemea msaada kutoka kwa wafadhili.
The school is allegedly operating in debt, with the parents now demanding for an immediate audit.
Shule kama hii yetu haiwezi kuwa inadaiwa pesa ambayo inakaribia milioni 4. Na ukweli wa mambo ni kwamba kile ambacho tunasikia kinaendelea hapa shuleni, paki nunuliwa kilo 5 za nyama, kule zinaandikwa kilo 10. Na halikadhalika mapochopocho yote ambayo yananunuliwa ni lazima yaongezwe. Hapo ndipo tumesomewa madeni ambayo ni makubwa. Ninaomba ingekuwa vizuri serikali ikaleta ikapafanya auditing hapa shule.
Tunadai mishahara kuanzia mwezi wa 7, wa 8, wa 9 na wa 10 pia inaonekana hatujalipwa mshahara. Tuna face hali ngumu ya kimaisha, tunasomesha, tuna rent, tunataka tulipe rent. Sasa ikiwa mwalimu wa FSC imeingia pesa kubwa ama pesa nzuri kutoka kwa FSC, unakuta mwalimu anatoa project za shamba.
The parents have threatened to withdraw their children from the school if their grievances are not urgently addressed. For Lunchtime News, I'm Safin Aching Ouma.
And from Kilifi County, we head to Kirinyaga County, where our reporter JJ Kioria is on standby with the Kirinyaga County Deputy Governor on the final touches of the preparations for tomorrow's Mashujaa Day celebrations in Wanguru Stadium in Kirinyaga County. JJ, kindly, what's the latest?
Back at Broadcasting House, and indeed we're still live from Wanguru International Stadium. This will be the venue of the 12th Mashujaa Day. Mashujaa Day is a concept brought about by the new constitution after the adoption of the 2010 constitution. That's when we switched from Kenyatta Day to Mashujaa Day. And before I tell you about the preparations, because we had a brief just about like 20 minutes ago with the PS Interior Karanja Kibicho, I'll be telling you what he said. But before we do that, I have the Deputy Governor, Kirinyaga County, Peter Ndamiri, who's in me on set, and we discuss a few issues about the preparations tomorrow. Thank you very much, DG, for being with us. Let's begin with the preparations around Mashujaa Day. Do you feel like Kirinyaga County is ready to host the 12th Mashujaa Day?
Well, one of the things I would want to mention is that not feeling like, but Kirinyaga is already in the mood of hosting the Mashujaa Day. So we are very much ready, members of public, members of the county, and everybody else, we are ready to host the 12th Mashujaa Day.
All right. Yeah. How do you feel since in normal area, when we were celebrating these celebrations before the pandemic, obviously people would fill the stadium to the brim. Only 3,000 people will be allowed in here, and they have been invited by CARD. How do you feel that probably a section of Kirinyaga residents will come in?
For sure, a section of Kirinyaga people are not very, very impressed, because they would want to come fill up this stadium to capacity, have the in-loads within this area also full to the capacity. But now they cannot do this because of course, the COVID regulations. And that is why we've been regulating to just about 3,000 people, whereas the capacity of this stadium is over 10,000. So really, I'm asking my fellow Kirinyaga men and women, they that cannot be able to come here, to just remain calm at home and watch from the television set. Mashujaa Day is not a Kirinyaga Day. It is actually a national event. It's a national celebration. They that cannot manage to come to the stadium, I'm actually urging them, wherever they will be, please just follow these proceedings of the celebrations from your distant safe home. Yes.
And that is very key and important. Much of what you're seeing is the face of a national government in these celebrations and the preparations that have gone into preparing Wanguru International Stadium in Kirinyaga County to be ready for Mashujaa Day celebrations. How much has, you know, the county invested in terms of ensuring that this event is successful tomorrow?
Well, I would want to assure you that as much as Mashujaa Day is a national event or a national celebration day, the county government has its pass or part within these celebrations. There are areas and there are costs that the county government had to meet. For instance, you know, there is the fixation and the payment of power and electricity bills. We have also to fix water within this facility, and many other things that the county has to do. In addition, the county government had to ensure that, and we have ensured that there will be good preparation on COVID issues should they arise. We've been able to vaccinate over 100,000 people just in preparation for this day. We also are going to have a fire extinguisher vans and lorries just to ensure that everything is in order. In addition to that, we have our ambulances which will be on standby, and we've also partnered with Muranga and the Embu counties, whereby they will give us their ambulances to just boost on what we have. Therefore, Kirinyaga County government has equally invested. As much as the infrastructure belongs to the national government, we also have a share in whatever is happening.
All right. Obviously, you are an invitee in this event, being the deputy governor, Kirinyaga County. But tell us how much has gone, or how the list of invitees, came to be. Your boss has complained that she only got 15 slots for invitation here.
Well, that is an area I don't want to dwell much on.
Okay.
But we agreed, and we were working hand in hand with the national government, and we agreed that this is good for politicians not to be able to bring so many people, because we don't want to spoil the mood of the celebration. If I were allowed, I would be able to bring the 3,000 around, and these people would come maybe and start singing my song. We want the president to feel loved by all. And we do not want the side shows where a politician brings a number and is the person to be celebrated alone. It's not us, it's about the national unity. And therefore, every person invited from Kirinyaga is my person. So I don't have to get 100 cans to feel that I've invited people. They that have been invited by me or by other persons are our people. And therefore, we are not going to do what we call robbing, to go and pay people to come to the stadium, that they may come and start, you know, celebrating us. We agreed it's a celebration for all, and we want the world and the entire nation to know Kirinyaga leaders are united in this, and we have put all our political differences aside,
right,
for us to have a beautiful day.
Interesting.
Yeah.
And obviously the entry here will be through cards. There will be green cards, there will be blue cards, and there will also be
red cards.
Red cards are for the VIPs. There's green cards and blue cards, and of course they will park in different places. There's one at Wanguru Primary School, the other one at the National
Gurubani Primary School. Then we have the Moyalized Mills,
okay,
at the National Irrigation Board premises.
All right.
We have those designated parking points. Yeah.
As we wind up, DG, what are the priority areas for the people of Kirinyaga? As the president visits the county of Kirinyaga, I'm sure obviously you have a raft of issues you would want the president to address.
Well, yes, and I would not want to preempt.
Okay.
Yesterday, he invited us at Sagana State Lodge. He came to Kirinyaga and we had a round visiting. And I can tell you something, my friend. The way I saw people enthusiastically celebrating the president yesterday, I'm telling you, and I want to make it clear that Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta is in charge of Mount Kenya region and is the man to watch. Mount Kenya is solidly behind Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta. And I'm telling you, even after Masujade, there's going to be political waves. People realigning themselves, because he's our kingpin, he's the person we are watching, he's the person reading us. I saw it yesterday, even as we went opening up places and, you know, doing inspections. And I'm telling you, after tomorrow, you shall be hearing great things here.
And you're running for governor?
Certain race.
Okay.
I am running for gubernatorial seat. I've been a deputy governor now for this few years. Actually, we are going to the end of the term. And I'm more qualified to take over the mantle of being the next governor of Kenya.
You have the experience?
Yes, I have the experience, I have the knowledge, I have papers. What more do we need?
All right.
And the people of this region, where we are celebrating Masujade, Moya to be precise, is the most populous, and it's my home area.
This is where you come from?
This is where I come from.
All right.
So Moya has said and made a declaration that this time round, the gubernatorial seat will be going on a rotational basis. Gishogo has had their term 10 years. Now it is Moya term to get another 10 years. Then we'll go to another sub-county. And I think we are in agreement.
All right, quite interesting.
Yeah. Legion of politics.
Thank you very much. Of course, that's how we wind up the interview. Metro Enjoy. We have comprehensive reports coming your way. You know, 7 p.m. bulletin and a 9 p.m. bulletin. So our viewers should keep it. KBC Channel 1, we are having this coverage back-to-back. Today, yesterday, and tomorrow, the culmination of this event being President Uhuru Kenyatta's speech when he addresses the 47 million Kenyans who are eagerly waiting for what he will say. Back to you, Ben Troy.
Thank you so much, JJ Kuria, live from the Wanguru International Stadium. They're engaging the deputy county Governor Peter Ndambiri. And away from the politics is that it's all systems go, the final touches and rehearsals there, as you have seen from those images. But unfortunately, some people are disgruntled that they will not be able to be in that stadium. But things are what they are because of the COVID-19 protocols, and only a handful will be allowed into the new stadium. But away from that, is that 100,000 people have been vaccinated, and also ambulances from neighboring counties of Embu and Murang'a are also on standby to ensure everything is spick and span. Of course, the deputy governor has said, is that you can follow all the live coverage right here on KBC. With pitched camp, will be there tonight and also the whole day tomorrow. In other news, elders from the Kaplel clan in Nandi County have conducted a cleansing ceremony in the house where athlete Agnes Tirop was allegedly murdered last week. Led by Kirwa Bitok, the elders slaughtered a sheep as part of rituals to exorcise the evil spirits.
This is the house where the body of the late Agnes Tirop was found lying lifeless on the morning of Wednesday, October 13th, 2021, while condemning the untimely death of the 25-year-old world marathoner. Elders from the Kapkel clan in Nandi County visited her home in Iten to conduct a cleansing ceremony at her house, slaughtering a sheep, sprinkling milk, and smearing cow dung as part of rituals to exorcise evil spirits.
Sasa sina wega mabuta, sina wega masiwa. Yote pamoja na mafuta tu. Mtu akiishi kwa hapo anakuwa mzuri. Kwa sababu sangine kama kokaa bure sasa na mna hata kokaa mwaka moja bila kufanya hiyo mila, mtu akiishi nyumba
kulingana na family. The family wamedeglea watu wahusika wasikuche kwa mazishi ya msichana wetu, na hatuna uhusiano na hawa.
Maana hata mimi sijui hawa, sijapeana mtoto. Mtoto ni yangu. Mtoto ni yangu, na wachakuja hata sichui wasasi yake. Sichui hawa, hata nikikutana na hawa, hawajui mimi. Wachakuja mpaka kombao ni yangu. Kwa hivyo, asijaribu marafiki zake, asijaribu kukuja mazishi.
The cultural rites happened hours after Ibrahim Rotich, the prime suspect in Tirop's murder, was arraigned in court. The late athlete will be buried on Saturday at her parents' home in Nandi County. For Lunchtime News, I'm Safin Aching Ouma.
Let's now shift focus to some politics, where the Orange Democratic Movement National Elections Board has assured its members of free and fair party elections in next year's party nominations ahead of the 2022 poll. The move coming at a time when disgruntled factions in the party have called for transparency in the nomination. The board says it has put up strategies that will ensure the party primaries are fair and instill confidence among its members.
After hue and cry over credibility and transparency of ODM primaries, the party's National Elections Board has moved to assure its members of free and fair primaries ahead of the 2022 poll. ODM next chairperson Catherine Mumo, who spoke in Busia, says the party is keen to change the perception of bias in previous primaries. According to Mumo, the party has put up strategies that will ensure the party primaries are fair and inspire confidence among its members and the public.
Tukirudi tumetengeneza sheria ambazo zitafanya uchaguzi wa primaries ambao unakuja uwe uchaguzi mwema.
This even as MPs prevailed upon the party to create an enabling environment for aspirants.
Tusisahau tuongee hapa tufikirie tu atakuwa ODM peke yake. It doesn't mean kama umeshinda nomination ya ODM tayari wewe umepata kiti yako. You'll still need support of all these other people to compete with the others. So tukiweka hiyo kitu maanani, I think at the end of the day We are saying things ambazo zitaisaidia kupatia chama msingi bora.
Meanwhile, Vihiga Senator George Haniri has expressed concern over poor voter registration turnout in the region, challenging area residents to take up the advantage of the ongoing mass voter registration by the electoral body and enlist themselves as voters.
I want you to have that, nataka mwe na hiyo silaha ya kura na kitambulisho. Kura na kitambulisho. Kwa hivyo wale watajiandikisha na waomba ya kwamba wajitokeze kabla wafunge kipindi hii ya madirisha ya ambayo imefunguliwa.
For Lunchtime News, I'm Gladys Mungai.
At about 23 minutes past the hour, we are taking our first break, but we still have more news on the other side of the break. Keep it KBC.
Usikubali kwa watu kuchafua serikali. Na usikubali kwa serikali aende kando. Ikiwa kama unaona sisi tuko na kasoro, sema wasi. Hapana hai, hapana kaa kimya. Utasema tu kwa sauti ya wale watu wenu ambao iko katika parliament. Kwa maana ikiwa kama wewe iko kwa kiwanjani ya mpira, kama wewe unacheza, unadhani wewe ndio unajua kushinda watu wote? Siko watu wengine huko nje baba anasema ah, kwa nini hapa napiga kule? Kwa nini yeye hapa anapiga kule? Kwa hivyo ukitiwaambia ati jaribu kuangalia kule na kule na kule, tena ufanye umoja, hii ndio tutasaidia.
Chawi ana roho chafu kama nini.
And your dad?
What about him?
Does he show you that he likes you?
My dad loves me.
Ungekuwa umejishughulisha na maisha yako hatungefika hapa.
Nyota wako iko salama.
You look so surprised to see me.
It's here, I'm shocked.
House ni mambo ya kawaida, mwisho atanyooka.
Kwangu sina muda. Wakati unayoona.
It has never been rosy for me. The people were watching from outside thought that I was enjoying too much. Not so. I benefited a lot. But equally, I suffered a lot.
How is it like working for the president almost round the clock? Join me, Kamche Menza, this Tuesday and Wednesday as I engage Lee Njiru, who worked for the founding father, President Jomo Kenyatta, and later President Moi.
Welcome back, and in case you just joined us, this is Lunchtime News. Moving on, motorists plying the Kenol-Sagana Highway are advised to divert to other routes following the anticipated heavy traffic due to the marking of Mashujaa Day in Kirinyaga County. Members of public attending celebrations are advised to access the venue via Kenol-Sagana Murua Road. Kenya National Highways Chairman Wangai Ndirango has urged motorists to ensure they follow the favorable routes in Murang'a County.
While inspecting the road, KENHA Chairman Wangai Ndirango tabulated other roads that motorists can use to avoid heavy traffic.
Safari yetu mvuna hiku barabara kwamba hiko tayari, sababu ya wale watu ambao tusafiri hapa siku ya Mashujaa. Pande zote mbili, tukielekea upande wa Kirinyaga na kutoka upande wa Kirinyaga kukuja Nairobi, pande zote ziko sawa sawa, zimefunguliwa na tutaweka maafisa ambao wataweza kuelekeza magari ile pande ambayo inafaa.
Chairman of Matatu Owners Association in Mount Kenya Region, Michael Karaoke, called on motorists to obey rules given by KenHa, stating that a major boost in the transport sector will be noted upon completion of the road.
Siku ya masujaa ningetaka kuomba washikandao waache kupitia hii njia, tuweza kupitia njia zile zingine ziko.
Some of the listed roads are Kenol, Muranga, Sagana, Nyeri route for passengers who will be headed to Nyeri County, as well as Nyoka Nyoka road. Those going to Embu can avoid the Kenol Sagana highway and divert to Kenol, Muranga, Sagana, Kirinyaga, Embu road. To ease traffic, KenHa has, among others, ensured a two-lane movement through the construction corridor, engagement of traffic marshals to direct flow, installation of road signs to enhance road safety, and opening of tarmac sections of the new road to traffic, among others. Reporting for Lunchtime News, I'm Wamboi Otiende.
Elsewhere, Embu County health workers have held demonstrations of poor working conditions in health facilities. The workers have accused the county government of failing to heed to their complaints, ranging from non-remittance of statutory deductions to partial payments of salaries, shortage of staff to lack of drugs and equipment in health facilities. Their strike is in its second week.
The angry workers, led by Kenya National Union of Nurses Embu Branch Secretary Masharia Kanderi, stormed the county offices, demanding to be addressed, vowing to continue with the strike until their grievances are addressed.
We are continuing with our strike. Our demand for that departure deduction payment have not been done up to date. It's about 3 months or 4 months. These people have not remitted whatever they have cut in our pay.
The workers also accused the county assembly of slashing the health budget of the highest, biggest public facility, Embu Level 5 Hospital, compromising service delivery.
Atuna staffs wa kutosha. Atuna medical supplies ya kutosha. Na hiyo kwanza tumeambiwa Simba ya mwenyewe ni yeye chairman wa budget and appropriation committee. Kwa hivyo yeye ni yeye amekata budget ya health services in Embu County.
The health practitioners say efforts to have their issues addressed by the employer have not borne any fruit, despite holding several engagements with the county leadership.
Tukikuja hapa kidogo, yeye tunaambiwa yuko Nairobi.
Moving on, a 32-year-old man has gone missing. Jefferson Mwangi Matere was missing last Thursday when he left his place of work at Missions for Essential Drugs along Mombasa Road at around 5 p.m. He was last seen wearing a white shirt and a navy blue khaki trouser. Information on his whereabouts can be channeled to the nearest police station. And China has successfully launched a manned spaceship, Shenzhou 13, and sent three astronauts in its space station called Model Tianhe for a six-month mission. The launch opens a new chapter for China's ambitious space exploration, and the manned space program is the second manned mission in the space station phase.
A Long March 2F Y-13 carrier rocket carrying the Shenzhou 13 crewed spaceship blasted off from the Jiguan Satellite Launch Center in the northwest of China. In the following 6 months, the crew will perform a series of tasks, including extravehicular activities, module transfer, supported by the robotic arm and manual teleoperation, to mark end of the key technology verification phase of the country's space station construction. The Shenzhou 13 spacecraft mission is a decisive and final battle for the key technology verification phase. It is also a crucial part of the entire construction process for the space station. For Lunchtime News, I'm Gladys Mungai.
Cotton farmers in Taita Taveta County are enjoying a bumper harvest of the new HBN hybrid cotton seeds. Various farmers in the semi-arid county say they have doubled their production since the hybrid cotton seeds were introduced in the market. Last year, Kenya approved the use of biotech cotton seeds after nearly two decades of intense lobbying and research.
The government says proper implementation of BT cotton farming is expected to increase revenue from 3.5 billion shillings in 2019 to 200 billion shillings by the year 2030. The cotton subsector is also expected to help create 500,000 cotton-related jobs and 100,000 from the apparel sector by 2025. BT cotton is a genetically enhanced seed through the incorporation of a gene derived from soil-occurring bacteria to protect itself against African bollworm, which is the most damaging pest to the crop. Following the distribution of BT cotton seeds last year, farmers in various parts of the country have started to enjoy improved production.
Na tunahimiza wakulima wapande kwa wingi kwa sababu cotton hii sisi wenyewe ndio tutainunua. Na tunawakika kwamba hii itatusaidia katika viwanda vyetu vya Kenya badala ya kuimport. Buy Kenya, build Kenya.
In Taita Taveta County, most farmers say they have doubled their production in the last year.
Tulikuwa tumeanza kitambo, tukaanza na hizi mbegu za zamani, lakini hizi mbegu zilikusumbua mpaka mwisho zikawa hazioti. Nazipanda, lakini hazimei. Na tukawa tunapata shida. Lakini kutoka mwaka jana, ndio hii experiment ikaanza ya kuleta BT cotton.
Cotton farmers in the county say increased cotton production is expected to spur activity in the manufacturing sector through the provision of raw material ginners, spinners, textile mills and apparel manufacturers. The chairlady of Pambani Mali Cotton Cooperative Society, Chausiku Ramadhani, urged the government to help cotton farmers access more markets for their products to improve their returns. Commercialization of cotton farming is expected to raise domestic demand to 260,000 bales from the current 140,000 bales.
Tukiendelea hivi, hakuna mtu ambaye atakuwa analilia njaa. Kama vile leo tumeuza pamba, tuna imani ya kwamba hata kwa yule ambaye hana chakula ndani ya nyumba ataenda kununua mahindi, ataenda kununua kile ambacho anachokitaka.
Reporting for Lunchtime News, my name is Hibak Said.
Nakuru business community is complaining that they have not benefited from the 4 billion shillings bailout package extended to the hospitality and service sectors by the government. The business community is now appealing to the government to lift the current night curfew imposed on businesses to tame the spread of COVID-19.
The last 2 years have seen many businesses in Kenya close shop in the wake of stringent COVID-19 control measures imposed by the government. To help the private sector recover, the government created a 6 billion shillings business rescue fund to be lent to struggling entities. However, business community in Nakuru County is protesting that they have not benefited from the fund.
Sisi kama wana mikahawa, kwa sasa tumefunga mikahawa na bar. 1015. Tumepoteza bilioni 150. Na wafanyikazi ambao tumepeleka nyumbani ni 1250. So hii ni wakati ambapo tunaona ya kwamba ni wakati tunafaa tupatiwe nafasi ili tuweze kufanya na kurudi kwenye biashara zetu.
The business operators drawn from the service industries as well as manufacturing sectors are lamenting the dwindling fortunes of their businesses, now calling on the government to lift the 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. curfew that has crippled the 24-hour economy, rendering thousands of workers jobless. Reporting for Lunchtime News, I am Teresa Mutai.
We'll be right back. Time to play, and reigning FKF Premier League champions Tusker FC left the country Tuesday morning ahead of their CAF Champions League second preliminary round return leg match against Egyptian giants Zamalek slated for Friday in Alexandria. The Brewers lost 1-0 to the five-time African champions in the first leg played on Saturday at the Nyayo National Stadium.
Tusker FC will be aiming to overturn a narrow 1-0 loss to Zamalek in the first leg played on Saturday at the Nyayo National Stadium. The Robert Matano Chargers held their final training session Monday before their departure Tuesday morning ahead of the crucial tie. Kenyan international Eugene Asike is optimistic the Brewers will put up a good fight in Alexandria.
We had our mistakes in the game, but also we had our positives, and I believe at this time when you're going to face Zamalek in Cairo, we need to focus as well on the positive side. There are things we did well, there are things we didn't do well as a team, and we acknowledge that, and that's what we have been trying to work on.
What we concede na kwenda wrong ni kwa tu kufunga tuko kimimi, yani kama kimimi venye nimeona tuko watu wako more, hiyo game imemotivate watu sana, watu wamekama positive sana kwa sababu tumefungwa home na ni bitter sana kufungwa home.
Tusker FC advanced to the first round of the competition after beating AS Artasol of Djibouti 4-1 on aggregate in the preliminary round, while Zamalek were among the top teams that received a bye to the first round.
Moving on, the Kenya Volleyball Federation 2021-2022 league season will kick off on November 26th at the Nyayo National Stadium. The men's first leg is slated for 26th to the 28th November at the Nyayo National Stadium, while the women's leg will be played on 27th to 28th November at the KPA Makande Hall. After the completion of the five legs, the national playoffs will be played on 24th to the 26th of June 2022. GSU are the reigning champions in the men's category, while Prisons Kenya are the title holders in the ladies' category.
The deputy principal of...
Will they get it right?
Yes, he has to get it right. Remember, we are having... we are at the end of the set. And as you can see, Equity are getting a point.
One man who's got everything right, it has to be Joshua Kiprono, the boy who is serving today. Up goes GSU, Cornelius Nagat, using his experience there. He goes for the float service, gets it over the...
Further afield, Liverpool goalkeeper Alisson Becker and midfielder Fabinho will return to the squad for Tuesday's Champions League group match away at Atletico de Madrid. But midfielder Thiago Alcantara remains sidelined with a calf injury. Meanwhile, Manchester City will be looking to get back to winning ways in the competition when they take on Club Brugge.
Champions League resumes tonight with 8 games on card, where Liverpool will be hoping to extend their unbeaten run in all competition this season when they travel to play Spanish side Atletico Madrid tonight. Atletico Madrid boss Diego Simeone has described Mohamed Salah as extraordinary before Tuesday's games with the Reds. Liverpool have been boosted by the return of the Brazil internationals Alisson Becker and Fabinho, who missed last weekend's 5-0 Premier League win at Watford after playing for their national team in the midweek. Liverpool are top of the Champions League Group B on 6 points from 2 games, 2 points ahead of second place Atletico Madrid, while Porto are third with 1 point and AC Milan bottom without a point. Meanwhile, Manchester City will be looking to get back to winning ways in the competition when they take on Club Brugge. Manchester City are hopeful that goalkeeper Henderson and striker Gabriel Jesus can feature in Tuesday's Champions League clash at Club Brugge, with the Brazilian pair already in Belgium. In other matches, Besiktas will play Sporting CP, while Shakhtar Donetsk will host Real Madrid. PSG will take on RB Leipzig, FC Porto will play AC Milan, Ajax will play Borussia Dortmund, while Internacional will take on Sheriff. Daniel Mwendwa, Sports.
And some good news for Arsenal fans. Alexander Lacazette's 96th minute goal secured a point for Arsenal after a 2-2 draw against Crystal Palace at the Emirates Stadium, extending Arsenal's unbeaten run to 5 games. Lacazette scored deep into injury time to deny club legend Patrick Vieira a winning return. That's where we put a cap on KBC Lunchtime News. Thank you so much for keeping me company. Remember, for more news, kindly check out our news handles and also all our social media spaces for more of this, plus much, much more. And also remember, our news tonight, Darubini, and of course the Prime Edition, will be live from the Wanguru International Stadium as we gear up for the Mashujaa celebrations tomorrow. Keep it KBC. My name is Ben Troy Njue, and Susan Thuku has been our sign language interpreter for this bulletin. Have a good one.
Vera Beauty and Fashion College, with branches in Nairobi, Eldoret, Thika and Meru. Did you know that we are a TVET approved institution? We offer courses in fashion design, interior design in soft furnishing, event decoration, flower arrangement, event planning, hairdressing, barbering and dreadlocks, beauty therapy, makeup, nail technology, spa massages, teaching skills, TOT, solo business management, and many more. Register now and visit our website on www.verabeautycollege.com. You can also call on 0725-923-550 Nairobi branch, 0728-087-689 Eldoret branch, 0722-227-428 Thika branch, 0725-000706 Meru branch. Vera Beauty and Fashion College, a TVET approved institution.
I'm still a bit worried. We've pushed Prince Chung into marrying you. Will it affect your future relationship?
Please don't blame His Highness. Believe me, it's killing him to do this. These days, he has to force himself to smile.
It's better for us if she dies. That way the Emperor and Prince Chung will take it out on the Empress Mother. And in order to finally beat Her Highness, the Emperor will do what needs to be done.
Yunxian, wake up!
2254 and beyond. What is popping? Well, I'll let you know what is popping on my end, and that is all the stories that went down over the weekend. That is events as well as the stories that trended, and a dope artist that I will be introducing to you guys. Let me know where you're tuning in from and just how you're loving the show so far. Well, we're just beginning, but I know you're gonna love it. My name is Vivian Dago. You can simply just call me Miss V, and you know what this right here is? Grapevine. What you gotta do? We kickstart today's party at the Carnival Grounds, where the October Festival is going down. Now, this year's October Festival will be taking place the entire month of October. And as I promised you last week, we are going to be bringing you all the action going down. Now, today, a number of performances are set to happen. Let's get into the Sherehe and see what's happening.
The October Festival is one of the biggest concerts in Kenya. It gives an opportunity for Kenyan artists to mingle, interact, and perform to their fans. This beer festival also stands out, as it is always headlined by Kenyan artists only, unlike most festivals and concerts where an international act closes the show. As promised, this year the festival is running the entire month of October, with up to 150 Kenyan artists set to perform across the country. Last Saturday, it was an all-live performance at the Carnival Grounds. It started off with a set from the DJ before the scheduled acts of the day hit the stage.
For life, let's do this for life. Make I tell you this, I wanna marry you twice. That will make me feel nice, make you be my wife. Let's do this for life.
Charisma opened the performances with his amazing vocals before inviting his former band members Le Band, and the fans love to see them together on stage.
Like sugar and spice and everything, now close your eyes and make you realize you're winning in life. Yeah, you're winning in life. You're number one, baby, you can call. Let me hear you sing.
Call me your number one. Baby, you can call me your superman.
Ethan Muziki as well as rapper Mbithi also got to entertain the revelers.
I'm on the right track. Negative with corona, positive with life. I have a dream for you, one boy will become a wife. She had my music and she told me she feeling my vibe.
Songstress Sero, who is an amazing live performer, brought her A-game and wowed the fans.
Cause I'm on my way to wrong kind, just to hear you tell a lie. Deep inside I wanna die, cause I see through your evil eye. One, two, hey! She'll put a smile upon your face and take you to a higher place. So don't you...
Closing off the performances was Soul Generation's Ben Soul, who gave those in attendance a taste of his artistry, from chill slow songs to the ones with a party and danceable feel.
Show me the green light, tell me you're alright. Take on a dawa, umepiga shower. Deep in this dark night, I'll be your moonlight.
Keep it Grapevine for more of what October Festival 2021
has to offer. Lucy, I love you. girl, no. Hey, don't force it.
On our link-up segment today, I am having one of the finest wordsmiths we have in the 254. He is from right here, the city of Nairobi, and he goes by the name Willy Oeba.
Hii swali ni offensive kama kwenda ukambani kuuliza when did the rain started hitting us. Tell me, what better they are doing if not playing us? Back to basics.
Hi, Oeba.
Hi.
How you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm good. It's good to have you on the show. Tell me about your poetry journey. Where did it begin and how is it going so far?
I started poetry way back in 2004. Yeah, primary school. Mm-hmm. But it was for competition. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I transitioned into high school. There's no one to write for me in high school. So I started writing on compositions, go to the national level. Mm-hmm. I started public speaking. Then when I cleared high school, now I started doing poetry because I realized people wanted to listen to the same things, but now out here you have to employ a lot of puns, a lot of metaphor. Mm-hmm. So, but now I started doing poetry on issues like activism and artivism and social justice in 2017. I realized people are going through a lot, the youths are going through a lot, this is what they go through on a daily, on a normal. Mm-hmm. I was doing pieces on peace and love, and so I started doing social justice to amplify voices.
Truth, life ain't easy, that's the hard truth. It's not about sagging drugs, though it create my wasted youth.
What do you feel about poetry at the moment in the country? Do you feel like people are embracing it?
Before, poetry was, we were cutting raising for music events, yeah? Right now we are collaborating with music artists, yeah. Hip-hop artists, mm-hmm. So we are getting there. We're not where we want to be, but most definitely we have to appreciate the fact that we are not where we used to be.
Unatafuta mapenzi wapi na we mwenye umeshindwa kujipenda. Mungu saidia watu jisaidia.
You're doing hip-hop now. Tell me about that. What made you want to transition and get into it?
Now, I linked up with an artist and producer from Tanzania. Mm. He's called Bear Beats. Yeah, so he's a very dope producer. He works with the likes of Akina Rostam, Stamina from TZ, Mawasama, Nacha. Mm-hmm. So we have done an album. It has 10 songs. Okay. It's dropping next month, but one December. Mm-hmm. So we did two projects for the album, poetry projects, and then he was like, I want you to try out something different. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So he came up with a very hard hip-hop beat. And I was like, hey, mm-hmm. It's been a very dope learning experience because we have to learn every day. I've done collabs with guys from Tanzania, Kina Nacha, Rostam, Stamina, uh-huh. Yeah. And zimetaona kuwa poa, zitakuwa kwa the album that is dropping in December.
Tunapoteza ndugu zetu kwenye ajali, wengine kwenye magonjwa.
When we are clapping for poets,
yeah.
We don't clap. We
snap.
Yeah, we snap our fingers.
Yeah.
What's the reason?
Poetry doesn't have a beat, or you might find it's live. So when you clap in between, some performers might lose the momentum, or they might forget. Mm. So when you clap, you interrupt.
Their trail of thought, right?
Yeah, the trail of thought.
Mm.
Like they get distracted.
Mm-hmm.
So when you snap, and they can continue, but sometimes the audience is overwhelmed, so they clap, and then now it is a challenge for artists, yeah, because now ni reflex action ikikubamba itafika point lazima to you clap, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a challenge to like practice a lot so that even when they clap, when you're distracted, you know how to like come back. Yeah.
Najua kesho sio certain, lakini death iko promised. Shida ni place na time to. What is life? Shida ni rhyme to. Make peace na the fact, no matter how good you are.
All I do is express myself, then people call that poetry. I find myself doing pieces that revolve around real human experience, like what I have gone through, what other people have gone through. Mm-hmm. So they speak to me at different times. But I really love the lyricism and the flow I employed on Dear God.
Dear God, at times when you bless, I didn't ask you to show God bless you. Over time, you may succeed.
Kuni make happy, I want to say I'm proud of you. kuna vitu mbosi me happen kwa life yangu looking back, that must have been you, you are love. Sijui kama ina make sense kusema
I'm falling in love with you. Dear God, lead us to come from you. But how we to nani aliwachagua, I'm certain not you.
So what goes through your mind as you're writing, and how long does it take for you to decide, yeah, I need to finish,
yeah,
an entire
wow
piece?
It really depends. There's a piece I have done, Dear God is the title track to my second album. So the album is called Dear God, so it has pieces like Dear Mr. President, it has This Girl's, Dear Dad, Dear Mama. So I was sending out letters on that piece. It was the album concept was letters. So it really depends. Like I was summarizing the whole album, and I really wanted to have a convo with God, yeah, like a one-on-one, like a normal human being who doesn't understand the concept of Christianity or religion, like what I would tell God on a one-on-one. Like on the piece Dear God, I've said Solomon had all he needed, angekuwa in my position better ange ask for food before we stop.
Realize church ndi huwa sometimes who an obstacle niki try to get to you. Hope una realize heart yangu ina get weary, una need to come through.
So I wanted to get inside the mind of like was a normal who are going through hard times and talk to God from that perspective, because as much as most of the time we want to be lyrical so that people listen, also there are stories that need to be told, and it's really hard to be emotionally correct and lyrically correct. Most of the times you have to sacrifice one, but with time now you get the gist.
Focus na negative lakini utaipata grammis jua ku act responsibly. Dear God, na kama watu wangekuwa wanafuata mawaidha watu wekea watu wengine.
Like when I was writing a piece, it's called This Girls, and we are doing now a campaign revolving around that. We are doing her dignity sanitary drive back in Nakuru. We have a CBO, it's called Vogue 254, yeah? And it's working with artists to bring change, social change through art. And there's a line I said in These Girls, I'll say it for the last time, no girl should miss school because of her menses, period. So that piece is supposed to bring about now the gender mainstreaming, talking about issues on gender equality, but now writing it, I wanted to write it so that even the men can appreciate it. So like the opening piece says, to all the girls who ever broken my heart, just know my mama doesn't like you. So it revolves around how like you people tell us the problem is me, not you, but the main concept is about now talking about the girls
like you. I write for girls who don't understand why I write. I write for girls who don't know I write. I write for girls who don't appreciate how I write.
What is your vision for the future for Willy Oeba, the poet,
wow,
or the artist in general?
Wow.